Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Critical Reactions with your host, Brian. Today we're going to be continuing on with New Releases Week, but instead of checking out a new band that released something new, we're going to check out a band that's been on the channel before. Today we're going to be looking at Oceans of Slumber. Dang, almost blew that. What a bad opening. So Justin has actually requested, he said, anything off of the new release. So I went looking in the... I went looking in the YouTube comments. Skold Buick has been asking about a return to the Earth Below. Nice, catchy mix of 80s ballads, prog, and doom, and maybe even a little R&B thrown in there. Yeah, so, sounds good to me. As long as it's along the lines of Winter, I don't think this can be bad. Winter was phenomenal. I fell in love with it. Just kind of that mix of doom, the doom essence, the doom atmosphere with a lot of the prog gear elements and hyper layering that went on. If this is anything like Winter, I don't even need to listen to it. I already know it's fantastic. But let's get into this. Let's see what's up. That dude's fills are insane as ever. Little bit of a time switch there. Raw power in the lyrics right there. Interesting decision on the synth sound there. Thank you. simple yet powerful. The only real movement is her vocals and the piano part. Yeah. That song hits, right? All right. Very different. It's not very different, but not everything I was expecting. It is a very different side of them from Winter. Whereas Winter, I felt, was a bit more proggier, had some more not doom metal parts in it. We had the guitar solos, we had the layered vocals, we had more upbeat sections, we had blast beats in Winter. This was almost pure doom. A lot of it was so heavy and cathartic. That last part was almost... like wading through sludge. It was just such a slow tempo. And just the whole song captures an atmosphere of unrelenting pressure. Except for the opening, which had those phenomenal drum fills to provide a lot of energy and momentum that is not seen throughout the rest of the track. It was very great. Contrast, providing context to the more slower sections. Contrast is actually a really good theme for this song. So right after the third section, we entered into the synth section. And we had a piano, I think it was, and then the synthesizer with the like an 80s synth wave kind of sound to it. And it was a very stripped back, minimal section, low volume. A drastic dynamic shift from everything else we had seen, and it led to almost a full bar of her singing practically by herself, not even singing, belting. I mean, she's just so much raw power behind these notes that she's just pumping out passion and power, definitely. And after that, we get this huge burst of sludge. It's not really a burst of energy. It is an explosive entrance for sure. It is heavy, it is powerful, it is loud, but it's not energetic. It is the slowest part of the song. And just that huge contrast from the meek and quiet with movement, even a little bit of movement, to the explosive and loud and angry in the end. And yeah, so I really dig that, how they showcase, they don't just show off their ability to have these moments of power or these moments of finesse. They really use it all to create context for the other, you know, for the opposite, create contrasting ideas. And I've said before that that to showcase an extreme, the best way to showcase an extreme is to have context. You can't show that 9,000 is a big number without showing the number one. Like, there's a huge gap between there, especially when we go over 9,000. Like, you need to have that context there. to know what it is. And the ending is big, it's powerful, it's slow, and it works best when you've experienced music that isn't big and powerful and slow. And yes, you can typically rely on your audience to have experiences with other music. It's not like every song that is that has extreme sections to it or is an extreme song needs to have contrast in order to kind of exemplify the extremity. But if you can work it into your song, it's going to make the more extreme parts even that more extreme, because it's going to have some relativity-ness to it. I don't think that came out right. being recently exposed to the opposite is going to make the extreme section feel more extreme because you've been recently exposed to its opposite. And I just think they do a phenomenal job at that. I did notice one thing, and that is they're missing a guitarist, which kind of sucks because here's what's up. There's no screaming in this or growling in this track. I don't know if that's the direction they've gone. I don't know if Winter was an outlier, but I've said this before, I'll say it again. I love the mix of cleans and heavies. I don't mind songs that are all clean. I don't mind songs that are all heavy. But I love the contrast of that, especially when, not just when they're done back to back, but when they're layered over top of each other. And Winter brought that in spades. We had three different scream styles. We had a growl. We had her cleans. I think at one point, like, two of the people were singing cleans. Two people who weren't the main singer were doing cleans. Like, there's just so much vocal texture happening. And this song, not diminishing the song at all, it fits well, especially if the song is about a singular person's experience, which is what it seems to be about. It makes sense to have a single voice. But just on a pure musical level, I miss the complexity in vocal textures. And timbres, even. I thought that's one of the things that really draws me to Winter, is the layering and the complexity in the timbres. And, this one didn't have that. And like I said, that's fine. Not every song needs to be the same, and it fits this song. It's a little disappointing that was one of the highlights for me, and I kind of attributed that to the band. I was kind of hoping that they continued doing that. And again, I don't know if this is the Fringe. I don't know if Winter was the Fringe. I don't know which one is more of their style or not. I've only heard two songs from them. But Winter is the one that I definitely lean towards more in terms of enjoying. But I don't think Winter can hold a candle to the oppressiveness that's happening here. All right, so we talked about contrast. And I think it's important to have the contrast. But it's also equally important to deliver on the contrasting elements as strongly as they do here. And that requires a phenomenal understanding and performance of what extremity you're trying to showcase, what extreme emotion you're trying to put on display. And that final minute of, unrelenting pressure and weight was just, golly, man. As far as we've checked out, we haven't really checked out a lot of doom metal. Even during doom metal week, we ended up with a lot of doom rock and kind of doom metal bands that have lightened up. So they were kind of gloomy, but they weren't heavy. We've had a couple of oppressive songs, but so far this one takes the cake. I have not delved too far into this genre, so I can't say with pure authority that this is the heaviest doom metal song out there. I'm sure that there is somebody who's created something insanely oppressive that I could not listen to, that I would not want to listen to. But I don't know if even this was a bit uncomfortable for me just to feel. I mean, it was just, it's gritty, it's crunchy. I mean, there has so much distortion to it. This, it sounds like the sound is about to break. There's so much distortion and compression going on the guitars. And it's just such a slow tempo. And it's just a loud, slow sound. Just these heavy beats coming down. Just, geez. The only thing that's really moving is the keyboard. And it's running, I don't know if they were arpeggios, but it was going up and down scales. Whatever scale the bar was on, or chord, that's what it was. It was going up and down chords. Whatever chord the bar was on, it would run up it. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do, something like that, and then it'd move on to the next chord. Really simple stuff, but providing the only movement against everything else made it seem more complex and actually added just enough energy to keep the song moving without just grinding to a halt. The only other thing that had a melody line with movement in it was her vocals, and they were just so harrowing and depressing and just... I don't know, there's like agony in her vocals, like she was drowning and reaching out for help or something, like last attempt at finding help with her problem, which, you know, the couple of scenes that I looked at, I really try not to watch music videos because I get sucked into them and then I don't hear the music, but I'm sure you noticed I checked in every once in a while because I am interested in some of the instrumentation that goes on. I like to see some of that stuff, especially those drum fills. And I did notice that there was a theme of being underwater and driving alone at night and stuff like that. So I think there's some metaphorical concepts here about, I don't know, heavy issues. You feel like you're drowning in the weight of them and stuff like that. And I can kind of see that last bit being like a final call for help before the issues or the pressure overtakes you and stuff like that. And it is heartbreaking, and a lot of that's the atmosphere. They do a fantastic job creating that oppressive atmosphere for her vocals, but still her delivery, the range, the power, the presence, the passion. We got the triple P's right there: power, presence, and passion. The way that she just delivers those vocals, it is heartbreaking. It is a hard ending to listen to, I think. So yeah, I mean, like I said, it is not what I was expecting, and I still think I prefer Winter as a song from them. But once again, these guys are just delivering on these heavy tracks. So yeah, Oceans of Slumber is definitely a band that I need to check more out of, especially since, like I said earlier, I am discovering Doom is kind of something I'm getting into. My only introduction to them prior was Anathema's Fine Day to Exit, which is alt doom rock, I guess. It's got some doomy elements, but it is also very much not doom. But yeah, the more doom stuff we check out on the channel, the more I'm getting into it. I don't know if it's just right place, right time kind of thing. I don't know if I had been introduced to this a year ago if I'd be getting into it. But, yeah, it's hitting right now. I'm really digging it. So, proper doom metal week. That's what we need to have, a proper doom metal week. Not to say that the last time we checked out doom songs wasn't fun. I mean, we had some really cool stuff back then. But, yeah, maybe we'll make sure we actually get doom metal tracks this time. I don't know. Anything more like this, I'd be happy with, honestly. This is where you guys come in. Don't hit me up. What'd you guys think of this Oceans of Slumber? Above the comments box, once you're done commenting, assuming you do. If not, that's cool too. Still love you. Thanks for the views. anyways, above the comment box is like, subscribe, and a bell. Ring those if you'd like to be notified about when I do new stuff. And they also help out the channel, YouTube algorithm, and all that garbage. I try not to worry about it too much, but, I mean, it is nice to have more people checking out my stuff, so, I don't know, if you want to help out the channel, that's the cheapest way to do it. Just push those buttons, takes 2 seconds of your life. And around there is a description box if you'd like to check out my Patreon, which is another way to support the channel. In exchange for that, you get to vote on future songs and themes, as well as join the Discord community, which we have had some We've had some fantastic conversation there. The old brain's not working today anymore. We've had some really good conversation over there, though, if you want to join that. It's only $1 at Patreon per month, and you get to join in on the voting and the Discord stuff. So, all right, I'll be back tomorrow, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 p.m. UTC, as usual, with another new release. Excited about all of these. I really like checking out new stuff. I don't mind checking out older bands. I love older stuff, but also it's always really cool to see, you know, what bands are up to these days. So I'm excited about this. I'm excited about most weeks. I think that's kind of a redundant thing to say these days. I'm like, yeah, I'm excited about what we're doing. Or, you know, the weekend comes around, I'm like, I'm excited about the special select. Well, yeah, duh. I mean, everything we do on this channel is awesome. There's been very few bands I'm like, don't ever want to listen to that again. But yeah, so it's kind of redundant. But I do enjoy checking out music, and part of that's new music. So I'm excited about this week because we're checking out new music. All right, I'm done rambling. You're probably done listening. Probably already turned this off already. You're like, what is this guy talking about? But if you're still here, stay fantastic, stay safe, and have an amazing morning, afternoon, or evening whenever you choose to watch my videos.